Melania Trump is making a slow return to the public eye after being out of sight for nearly a month, putting out her first statement on her Be Best campaign since her surgery, and carrying out a series of public appearances. Her disappearance after she underwent a kidney procedure, followed by later comments from President Donald Trump that she had a four-hour operation, led to a rash of conspiracy theories about her hospitalization and questions about why there were no photographs of the First Lady meeting with her staff, as her office claimed she was. Her office has repeatedly said the First Lady is fine and been meeting with staff on upcoming events and her Be Best project. And now Melania Trump is making her comeback. On Monday, her office released a statement with the First Lady praising the Department of Health and Human Services for its new guidelines on how states can cover the cost of treating babies suffering from neonatal abstinence syndrome, otherwise known as opiate withdrawal. "It is our responsibility to do all we can to ensure our most vulnerable are protected," she said. In October, the First Lady visited Lily's Place, a rehab drug center for infants in West Virginia. Melania mentioned that visit and her new Be Best program in her statement. Be Best is dedicated to bringing attention to successful programs like Lily's Place, because our nation needs more programs like these to help struggling Americans. "I am proud to support HHS in its continued efforts to combat the opioid epidemic," she said. The First Lady announced her signature initiative 7 days before she went to Walter Reed Military Medical Center on May 14 for an embolization procedure. In her Be Best announcement, she vowed to help kids be best and called for children to develop positive online behaviors and choose their words wisely online and learn to speak with respect and compassion. Her office said she's been meeting with her staff on her signature initiative while recovering from her procedure. "It's been a slow rollout for the notoriously private First Lady." Her statement followed her low-key appearance last Monday, her first sighting since her surgery, where she attended a Gold Star family's appearance at the White House. It was closed press, which allowed her office a measure of control in that it was able to put out its own photos of the event, although the Daily Mail.com obtained an image of the First Lady honoring the families who lost a loved one in the military. Melania Trump has come out her shell a bit more since then. The First Lady made a solo stop at a tribute to former President Abraham Lincoln at Ford's Theater Sunday evening, wearing a black $2,700 escada gown. "I was honored to be part of such a special evening," she said in a statement. As honorary co-chair of the occasion, she also delivered remarks to the audience. She attended alone as President Trump is in Singapore preparing for his meeting with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. The First Lady did not accompany him to Asia for the historic meeting, nor did she travel with him to Canada for G7 gathering before he flew east. Trump on Friday, before he left for Canada, said that her doctors have prohibited her from flying for a month. "Can't fly for 1 month, the doctors say," he said. "She wanted to go," Trump said. "She had a big operation that was close to a four-hour operation. And she's doing great." That assessment appeared far more serious than what the White House had previously said, that she had undergone a procedure. The procedure, an embolization, commonly takes up to 3 hours, suggesting that the one performed on the First Lady was more complicated than the average. Trump's use of the word operation differs from the statement put out by her office when it announced she was hospitalized. The statement said she had an embolization procedure for a benign kidney condition. She remained in the hospital for 5 days afterward. Melania Trump made her second public appearance since her kidney surgery Wednesday afternoon, when she joined the president at a briefing on hurricane preparedness at FEMA. Trump reassured her people love you, honey, after he tore into the fake news in a Twitter rant defending his wife and accused the media of covering up the First Lady's recovery along with promoting vicious rumors about her. He noted she went through a little rough patch, but she's doing great. The people of our country love you. Thank you, honey. She did not speak at the briefing, but held hands with her husband on her return to the White House. Melania Trump didn't attend an event with the First Lady of Japan on Thursday. Mrs. Trump had a previously scheduled event with her son and was regrettably not able to host Mrs. Abe. The First Lady's communications director Stephanie Grisham told DailyMail.com. Her last public appearance before her surgery was on May 10, when she joined her husband to welcome the return of three Americans who were being held captive in North Korea. Another outing may be in the works soon. Grisham told the DailyMail.com in May. The First Lady has also been working on upcoming projects like the annual White House Congressional Picnic and 4th of July plans. No date has been set for this year's Congressional Picnic, but last year's took place on June 22 on the White House South Lawn.